And this is your election headquarters, and we continue to bring you election-related news. Now, the elections are over, apart from the fact that the NDC is still contesting some of the results. Some successful candidates have been sharing their experience with Joy News. For a good number of them, 2020 has been tough, and there was some fierce contest for them. That's the story of the Member of Parliament elect for the Banda constituency in the Bono region, Ahmed Ibrahim, who says this year's general election has been the most difficult for him because his opponent got support from the entire government machinery to compete with him. He spoke to Joy News' Nesta Kafuyachama at Banda Ahinkro in the Bono region after he emerged victorious as MP-elect.
Ahmed Ibrahim says several forces fought against him for the Banda seat this year.
I was the only constituency in the region being held by the opposition, and I hold a strategic position in parliament. So all forces came against me. You can imagine a government who left even his strongholds and was constructing your road. So, oh, I will use this road to unseat the incumbent MP. So even the government left the major roads in his own strongholds and has lost those areas and was constructing the orphan one so that he will win this one to go and be added. That was the government strategy. And I'm coming from the opposition. Don't forget, they said if they won Banda and lost even 5 seats in the Bono region, they like it. And that was their formula. And Buidan is also here. That was also greatly used against me. Stars were campaigning. Programs were being organized against me. Monies were being given to my opponents to campaign against me. And being from opposition, I could not even give 50 Ghana, 20 Ghana, or 100 Ghana. So if you look at the votes in Banda, the strategy of my opponents and the government was that they will use resources to take it from me. They brought about 100 motorbikes. I couldn't afford to buy even one. They brought about 200 sewing machines. I could buy only about 70 or so. Every household was given 1 cloth, 2 million, 1 cloth, 2 million, 1 cloth, 2 million. People took the money and went and voted against them.
According to Ahmed Ibrahim, even though his contender committed more resources to the election, the people rejected him.
There were a lot of skirt and blouses. People didn't like man opening, but he was being imposed with resources on them. That is why if you look at even the presidential, we lost the presidential by slim margin. Yet still, by the grace of God, I was able to win the parliamentary. That's why I wouldn't want to be ungrateful. This was the only major road in the constituency. And the contractor was working in the communities and let even the other portions or sections of the road. Oh, let me go to the community and be working, to be seen to be working. Oh, we'll use this one. So everyone who can also look at the road. The president as a sitting president has been here twice. The vice president as a vice president has been here twice. The second lady, Tamira Baumia, has been here twice. Osafumafo, the senior minister, has been here. So it's like all their major forces, John Boyd, all their forces were here. But I'm only a little fish. I had to manage to come with General Mosquito and Alban Bagbe. They've helped to make sure that I have won. But the good news is that the integrity and the credibility inculcated in the normal or ordinary Banda citizen.
Should this be the last time the Banda constituency is represented by Ahmed Ibrahim in parliament?
I don't enjoy power, and I'm not the power drunk type of politician. So I will go and consult with my people. What is your take? If you think enough for me, then I exit. If you think I should still represent your interests, then I continue.
Nestor Kafui Ajuma's report for joining us.